In this video, I'm going to talk all about how I work a hive. What I do is I go from the top of the nest to the bottom of the nest, and things that I'm seeing on the way through that I'm actually looking for to ensure that my colony is healthy and productive. But before I do that, I want to point out two things that you should notice while I'm standing by this hive. Number one, I have on a veil. Now, I know that you'll watch videos of beekeepers all around the world approaching colonies, working colonies without a veil. That can be very dangerous, and I never recommend it. I always tell people, when you work a colony, you should at least have a veil on from a personal protective equipment perspective. The second thing I'll do is I will always ensure that I have my hive tool and my smoker handy when I work a hive, because frankly, these are the most essential tools that you need when you're going through a hive. So with a veil, with a hive tool, and with a smoker, I can do just about anything with a beehive. So the first thing I'll tell you, now that I've told you all of those pieces, is when I approach a hive, I do not work the hive from the front. When you're out in front, you're blocking all the bees from coming back in to their hive. I don't work the hive from the back because it's awkward to have to pick up frames in this direction. I prefer to work hives standing beside the hive. In this particular case, our arrangement is such as that we have about a 6 or 7 foot beam here that the colonies, two colonies sit on. That leaves us a space between these two colonies where we can put things while we're working hives. So I've got this hive here. The bottom of that hive is about the height of my knee, and it makes where I'm not bending all the way over to the ground. When I get beside a hive, I typically plant my feet, because while I'm working a hive, bees may fall out. I may sit a frame down beside me, and I don't want to squash bees. And with all of that in place, it's time to go in. So this particular hive configuration is a deep and a medium, and those two are separated by a queen excluder. So this medium is the food reserve for the bee. The bees have this food available to them throughout the year. We never touch it, we never harvest it here at the University of Florida. So in this configuration, this super belongs to the bees. But I don't really need to see in it. With this excluder, there should be no queen and no brood upstairs. Really, all I need to know is that it has honey, and I can judge that exclusively by its weight. So as I approach this hive, I get my smoker and I smoke the entrance of this hive. I remove the brick that we keep on top of all of our hives, and I don't even bother taking the lid off of this box, because I can know everything I need to know about this super simply by the weight. So I'll get my hive tool, pry off this super, and I sit the super on the stand beside this hive. This is really why we like these stands here at the University of Florida. It keeps it from us from having to bend over and put things on the ground. Also notice that when I took off this super, I didn't sit it down flat. If I had done that, I had a risk of killing bees. I didn't sit it on its side. If I had done that, the frames might have rocked together and killed bees. I stood it on its end. It's low impact to the bees. So I am going to smoke underneath the super just a little bit. And I'm also going to smoke right here on top of the brood chamber a little bit. Now my feet are planted. My smoker is handily accessible, and I'll use my hive tool to remove the queen excluder. In a typical colony inspection, I'm not doing anything overly complicated to this hive. I just want to make sure that there are no unchecked diseases or pests, and that the queen is present. I was able to judge by removing the super that they had enough food. It was sufficiently heavy, and so I know that they're okay from a food perspective. So now I'm just checking diseases and pests in the presence of a queen. Remember, anytime you remove a queen excluder, the queen can be underneath it. So I always like to prop it up on the ground outside of the hive, so if I've missed her, she can crawl up and go into the nest. I never rest a queen excluder on the super, because if I missed her, she might go into the super and she'll forever be there. So now with the excluder removed, I'm going to smoke the bees lightly, and I'm going to invite you to come in and take a closer look in the brood box with me. Now, everybody's different when it comes to working bees in the nest. A lot of people will start with the first frame. You know, there's 10 frames in this nest. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'll refer to the frame based on the number they are from me, with the closest frame being frame 1. I'm one of those beekeepers who likes to remove frame 2. I think I have a little bit more control and a little bit more space to do that. So all I do is pop one end of the frame loose with my hive tool. I pop the second end of the frame loose with my hive tool, and I grab that frame and I slowly remove. I don't yank, but I slowly remove this frame from the nest. Remember, let's just do a little bit of frame math. This frame has an exposed side when I'm removing it. It has a second exposed side when I'm removing it, and it has an exposed side on this frame, an exposed side on this frame. That means there's 1, 2, 3, 4 places the queen can be. And so if I yank this frame out of the nest, there's a risk of damaging the queen. So I always remove it slowly. And once I have that frame out, I look at it to make some decisions about that frame. So some things that I see here. Number one, they have capped honey up here in the corners. Number two, I see that it has they have a lot of bee bread stored here. So this is not a frame of brood, it's a frame of honey and bee bread. So in other words, a frame of resources. And I flip it and I see exactly the same on this side. I see a lot of bee bread stored in the cells here. I see a lot of honey stored in the cells here, which means this second frame was a frame of resources. I'm looking at the bees, they all look good, no tattered wings. Of course, there's no brood here to assess, but everything looks good to me on this frame. Now, what I like to do with this frame is I like to sit this frame outside of the hive. In this case, I'm putting it on the ground, but I might have a frame rest here that you could put the frame into. Those frame holders, I really like those. And the reason I've left it out of the hive is it's much safer to work a colony by taking out one frame and leaving it out and then working subsequent frames than working that frame and putting it back in and taking out the next frame and putting it back in. What I've done is I've left myself a frame space that I can use to manipulate the other frame. So I'm going to lightly smoke these bees. I'm making that decision based on the fact that when I work these frames, the bees have been chasing my hands a little bit. I haven't been stung yet, but the fact that they're chasing my hands indicates to me that they need to be a little bit smoked. So now I'm going to remove frame 1. That would be the one nearest me. And if the nest configuration is typical, I expect this to be mainly resources, because bees tend to put resources on the outer combs. Sure enough, I look at this frame and I see capped honey here. I see a little bit of bee bread there. So this is, in fact, a resource frame. The bees themselves look good. There's ample resources in this frame. And of course, I've already inspected frame 2, and I know that there's ample resources there. So in a typical hive, resources are usually stored by bees on the outermost frames, and you have brood on the innermost frames. So as I move away from the wall, I expect to see brood. So I'm going to take out this next frame and see if I start seeing that. Slowly pull it out. Aha! And I do see brood. I do see brood. It does still have a lot of pollen and honey stored, so bee bread and honey, but I do see some capped cells here that are brood cells, and I am looking into the back of these cells and I see that there are eggs in those cells. Now, in a typical situation, what I have seen, the population of the bees, the resources, the weight of that super, the fact that there's brood and eggs, I've personally seen everything I need to see. The queen's here, I don't see any unchecked diseases and pests, etc. So I would put this hive back together and move on. But for purposes of this video, I do want to go into a couple of additional brood frames to see if we see anything there that might be alarming to us. So in this particular case, I'm just going to remove this. I'm going to put this frame back into the hive. And I'm going to now remove the next frame. My guess is as we move closer to the nest, we'll get more and more and more brood. So I pull this frame, and sure enough, considerably more of this frame is brood. There's a lot of open cells here. I can see eggs and young larvae in them. I see a little bit of capped brood there. So my guess is the queen is running around in this nest and doing just fine. In fact, I see quite a bit of capped brood here. It looks good. Everything looks good to me. The bees are happy, healthy, lots of brood, lots of resources, and I've seen really everything that I need to see. Now, a lot of beekeepers, especially new beekeepers, think that it's necessary to see the queen on each inspection. I don't share that philosophy. If you see eggs, the queen has been present in that nest in the last 3 days. Remember, eggs last up to 3 days. So when you see eggs in the nest, the queen was there within the last 3 days. The fact that there were no queen cells, the second fact that there were eggs, both of those facts lead me to believe she is present and life is good. So again, there are lots of different reasons I might go through this hive. I might go through to cut queen cells for swarm production. I may be going into it to make a split, etc. But on a typical average inspection, you just need to make sure of 3 things. They've got the resources they need, the queen is present, and there's no unchecked diseases or pests. The bees look healthy, the brood look good, the queen was present, they had ample resources. This hive is good. So now that we've gone through the brood nest, we've seen everything's okay, the queen's present, there's no unchecked diseases and pests, the honey is present in the super where I need it to be, I can assemble all of this back together, know that my colony's looking good, and then I can move on in the apiary to inspect the next hive. Thank you for joining me on this visit to this particular hive.